Hello everyone, I am glad to present the work with the title The Influence of Stress Ratio on Structural Fatigue of Pseudoelastic Knee TLOI. A lot of structures and elements that made of shape memory alloys operate under low cycle fatigue, so it could be application in civil engineering. So most studies of mean stress effect are related to high cycle fatigue, and also the fatigue failure criterion is mainly applicable for high cycle fatigue that was proposed earlier. So there are known only some studies regarding the effect of stress ratio on the fatigue failure criteria and the low cycle fatigue. And also it is not clear whether it can be used to evaluate the durability of materials and structural elements made of shape memory alloys, taking into account the effect of stress ratio under low cycle fatigue. So the aim of the work is to study the effect of stress ratio on low cycle fatigue of pseudoelastic knee TLOI under uniaxial tension. So pseudoelastic shape memory material was used in this study. The chemical composition of the knee TLOI are 55.78% of nickel, 44.12% of titanium, and remaining other components. The phase transformation temperatures were identified using differential scanning calorimetry, so the deathsuckers show the forward and reverse phase transformations occurring in shape memory alloy during the heating and cooling cycles relatively. So the austenite finish temperature is minus 38.7 Celsius. Mechanical properties was defined at the 0 Celsius, where the material show pseudoelastic behavior. The following mechanical properties are presented in the table. So yield strength is 447 MPa, ultimate tensile strength is 869 MPa, and two Young modulus, austenite and martensite, are 25.3 and 16.8 gigapascal respectively. Spacemans were machined from the rod of 8 mm in diameter. The fatigue tests were carried out at 0 Celsius temperature under the uniaxial tension of cylindrical spacemans with the diameter of 4 mm and gauge length of 12.5 mm. Spacemans were tested in chamber with ice and ice water. The extensometer was mounted using extenders. The tests were carried out on servo-hydraulic testing machine STM-100 with automated control and data acquisition system, sinusoidal loading with a frequency of 0.5 Hz was performed. Typical hysteresis loops are presented for both stress ratios 0 and 0.5. Stress control tests were performed at stress ratio 0 and at stress ratio 0.5. The strain control tests were performed. Low cycle fatigue curves of knee TLOI at 0 Celsius and stress ratio 0 and 0.5 are presented on the left figure. The stress range corresponds to stabilization region at the number of half cycle to failure, So with the increase of stress ratio from 0 to 0.5, the fatigue lifetime of Nitti alloy decreased significantly under the same stress range. Experimental data on the low cycle fatigue shown on left figure were plotted according to the failure criterion of the specimen and could be well enough described by power law function formula 1. So the parameters in these equations were determined by fitting of experimental data. Similar effect of stress ratio on fatigue lifetime was observed while using stress strain range as a failure criterion. The strain amplitude and the number of cycle to failure under low cycle fatigue are described by the empirical relationship, the formula 2. The fatigue lifetime was also estimated using the Odqvist parameter, which characterizes the accumulated plastic strain and under uniaxial cyclic loading is determined by formula 3. According to the left figure, the Odqvist parameter is linearly proportional to the number of loading cycles before failure of the specimen and well described by the dependence 4. The dependence of the dissipated energy density on the number of cycles to failure at 0 Celsius and stress ratio 0 and 0.5 are shown on the right figure. The dissipated energy density value corresponds to the stabilization region at the number of half cycles to failure, and the dissipated energy per cycle was calculated as the difference between the areas of loading and unloading lines under stress strain curves by means of numerical integration. The dependence of dissipation energy density on the number of cycles to failure in the case of low cycle fatigue is described by the empirical equation 5. Upper figure shows the dependencies of the damage parameter on the number of cycles to failure at both stress ratios 0 and 0.5. This parameter was calculated by formula 6. It should be noted that the Young modulus of austenite and maximum stress were used on the stabilization region for calculation elastic energy density. Also, another energy-based criterion of fatigue failure could be used, this criterion based on sum of total energy density and could be calculated by formula 7. As could be seen from on the lower figure, this parameter is in good arrangement for various cyclic loadings, stress ratios and two-step variable amplitude loading. This figure presents the comparative dependencies of the total strain energy density, total elastic strain energy and total dissipation energy of Nitti alloy upon the experimental lifetime at both stress ratios 0 and 0.5 under 0 Celsius. In general, with the increase in the number of loading cycles, the relative contribution of dissipation energy to the total strain energy density decreases. In addition, the variation of the experimentally determined total dissipation energy far exceeds the variation of the total energy of elastic deformation. It should be also noted that the dependencies of the total strain energy density and total elastic strain energy almost coincide. From the mentioned above fact, it can be concluded that the fatigue fracture is controlled by the total elastic strain energy and to a lesser extent by a dissipated energy up to the moment of failure. Lifetime comparison of pseudoelastic knitted alloy determined from the experiment and calculated by the criterion of the total energy density on the left and the criterion of the elastic energy density on the right are presented. As follows from the analysis of this data, the difference between these criteria does not exceed 0.6%, so this indicates the dominant role of the total energy density in the fatigue failure of pseudoelastic knitted alloy under low cycle loading. So thus, the fatigue damage criterion based on the total energy density can be used to predict fatigue life at constant amplitude, take into account stress ratios. The figures show the dependencies of the modulus of elasticity of austenite on the residual strain for different stress ratios. At the same value of the residual strain, the modulus of elasticity at stress ratio 0 and stress ratio 0.5 are significantly different. This indicates that modulus of elasticity and elastic strain energy depend on amplitude under the same values of maximum stress. There were used stress, strain, and energy-based criteria to study the dependencies of stress ratio on low cycle fatigue of pseudoelastic knitted alloy. There is justified the low cycle fatigue failure criterion of shape memory alloy that takes into account the stress ratio, the total elastic strain energy density. The dependencies of total strain energy density and total elastic strain energy almost coincide. The greatest error is the relative error between the experimental and calculated values of fatigue lifetime of shape memory alloy according to total strain energy density criterion that does not exceed 15.8%. That is almost the same as the prediction result that were obtained according to total elastic strain energy.